Well, welcome to part two, talking about MATLAB and multiple programming languages. Today, we're going to focus on artificial intelligence. So, Heather, how important is MATLAB and Python integration for artificial intelligence?
I'm glad you asked. Thanks, Bill. That's very, very important. You may know that MathWorks has been supporting deep learning AI for a very long time. I think the neural networks toolbox was 1992. So that was a long time before it was cool. but many people have been doing research in MATLAB for many years. And of course, we've heard about Python just exploding over the last few years with AI. So especially in the engineering community, we want to be able to take advantage of all this great work all around the world and in whatever language you want. So it's really, really important from a research perspective. And then it's also really important for just an engineering perspective, right? Where you have, let's say, a Python model, a TensorFlow, PyTorch thing that you heard about or a colleague is using, and you still want to be able to use MATLAB for your signal processing, for your, you know, hardware integrations, your plotting, interactivity, those sorts of things. So we see, you know, MathWorks in the community, we see a lot of people using this for that very reason, you know, taking this latest, greatest model that has been done in PyTorch, and then bringing it on into MATLAB and doing all your standard, awesome MATLAB data analysis, signal processing, you know, deployment things.
Can you talk a little bit more about how MATLAB is integrated with those platforms? You mentioned TensorFlow and PyTorch, for example.
Sure. Yeah. And there are two important ways that they're integrated. So the first way is through interoperability, or basically just kind of using the languages side by side, right? Like calling one from the other. So I think of this as more of the development phase. And then the other way is a model conversion. And so that's a little bit more when you are satisfied with the model and then you want to convert it and carry on, make it a MATLAB model, and then do your deployment. And so those are the biggest ways. And again, those are two sort of different cases. Some of them kind of go hand in hand, where you do a bit of the side-by-side, you know, co-op programming, basically, where you're tweaking some information or tweaking some code in Python, tweaking something in MATLAB, you know, you're calling either language. And then, you know, the latter being the model conversion where, okay, we're good. Let's put it onto our system, or, you know, put it into our hardware now and start testing, you know, things like that.
So when you're setting out to solve real world problems with artificial intelligence, how does this integration fit with that effort?
Thanks. That's a great, really important question, especially, again, like you said, as it's solving some real world problems that maybe we're involved with. It's really important to think about this because, you know, we talked about the sort of explosion of Python models and all this wonderful research with Python. But then there is that next step that we talked a little bit about, which is actually having this implemented on hardware, or actually having this real time, you know, used in a system. And that's not quite as straightforward. So the, and it hasn't had the historical, you know, experience that MathWorks has had in this area, where, you know, it's MathWorks is very used to having folks with regulatory challenges and, you know, having to communicate and test it, like very, very serious testing. And that isn't necessarily the case for the AI research community, although they do great testing. So it, again, taking that next step into the reality of it all, it's very, very important because you can just go ahead and use those models, you know, your favorite, and then bring it in, do that very serious testing, all of the edge cases, the simulations that you need to do, and in the tools that, you know, you're familiar with and, you know, trusted for the more numeric and hardware challenges that we talked about.
All right. So how is MathWorks utilizing MATLAB and Python so that programmers and engineers can develop these applications? Is it integrated into the MATLAB IDE, for example?
That's great. There's actually a couple of different ways. You know, we talked a little bit about the APIs, which pretty straightforward. There's also a live editor task. So you can just have a little app essentially in your program, and then you can just pop in the Python code right there. Mm-hmm. The other thing is that, you know, of course, recognizing that not everybody's familiar with every language, you know, making it as easy as possible. So let's say your Python code is something you found and you just want to copy paste. You can do that. You could call from a script, you could call a function, a class, you know, so really trying to ensure that all skill levels are going to be supported in this game. Because as you mentioned before, it's important. People are going to be using it. They need to be confident and, you know, should be supported regardless of skill level. They shouldn't need to feel like they need to go learn everything about Python just because they want to use their colleague's model. Right. So really trying to enable that. There are a couple of really good, well, starring me, a couple of good tutorials and things to get started and to think about some of those integration challenges, in addition to all of the tooling that we've been talking about. And of course, importantly, last but not least, I suppose, having those model conversions so that, again, you can really just take that next step. As an engineer might be familiar with, you've got it in MATLAB, you go ahead and test and go ahead and deploy onto your hardware and you're set. So hopefully that helps.
Definitely. Well, stay tuned for part three, where we'll be talking about integrating two programming languages together, one of them being C++. So thank you very much, Heather. See you then.